everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Reaction Therapy. I am Tom Stevens, your host and resident psychotherapist, here to break down the lyrics to some of your favorite music. And today, you can hear it. It's in my voice. It is none other than Juice WRLD Day. That's right. Juice WRLD time is here again. Cannot wait for this. I'm still is the title today. I'm still, and I can't hardly sit still for waiting for this song. So before we get into it, one more time, thank you to the Juice WRLD family for welcoming us in. Nick and I just love y'all and the chance to spend all this time with you, and for the growth of this channel to play more Juice WRLD. Give me your comments. Give me your insight. Give me your perspective. We do love hearing it. So without further ado, let's get into Juice WRLD. I'm still. This is really different for me. I didn't expect this. Like, this is like some combo for him of a mellow pop song and him just spitting out the lyrics again about his life and what he's been through. And this has kind of got that almost acoustic melody in the beginning where it just kind of gets you going. It's nice little melody. I like it. And he's just kind of spitting out the lyrics along with it, which is, I think I kind of like this. I mean, it's not the hard beat and nothing's dropping hard with it, but it's really, this is cool. I like this. I want to hear it again, because when I heard the lyrics immediately, I thought, well, this is classic Juice, right? I mean, he's talking about regrets. He's talking about, you know, other people, and points out somebody that made the list of regrets. I don't know if it's a past relationship that he had with a girl or if it's a past friendship that he had, but here he goes. My step, I'm listening, regressing, you made that. Yep. List. You're my depression. Your first impression wasn't deception. You were lying. Bitch, I'm still flexing with my heart broken. Get my heart open. I'm not high. He is mad at somebody. Y'all, this is what makes us relate so well to music, because when we find somebody we like that writes words, it's almost like they're writing words that are speaking directly to us. And so sometimes you hear a lecture in class or somebody who goes to church and they hear a sermon from a preacher, and it's like they're speaking directly to me. And in this case, it's the lyrics. Like, wow, anybody ever been through this? And you can apply it anywhere, but just think of a relationship, think of a job, think of a hard situation in life with other people. And it's like, I put myself out there, my heart got broken, and man, I'm still flexing, even though his heart is broken. I'm still fighting through this, and I'll be fine, and I'm gonna make it. But man, I cannot believe this just happened. And almost like, I cannot believe you would do this to me. So to me, mental health wise, that's why I love journaling. That's why I love getting things out for people, is write this stuff down, speak it out, say it out. Even if you have to go in the shower and scream, or go out to a park where there's nobody around and scream, do something to get this out of your system so that you don't carry it around and stay toxic. With my heart broken, get my heart open, I'm not hiding. Bitch, I'm still moving, I'm in slow motion. I roll my dosage, I'm getting higher. Bitch, I still love my pills. I feel you can't feel, I feel you can't feel. He is serious about whoever or whatever this is, because it's like labeling each time. You know, I've got something that I can hang on to. I've got something that fills my need. Now, you know, I don't like that as far as the using and the drugs, because I don't think it's actually, I think it's just filling a hole. It's like a Band-Aid. It's like it's covering something up. It's like makeup on the face. When somebody puts makeup on, because it covers that up. It's like me putting a cap on, you know, my bald head. It's like, well, you wouldn't know, I guess, I was bald if I had a cap on. However, what's underneath is very different. And so he keeps talking like, I'm fine. I've got this. Like, this can fill my needs. I don't need you. But man, he sure sounds bitter. Interesting here that, you know, he talks about a lot of what he's fine, he'll be fine, he'll be okay. But in reality, like, he's not okay. He's just trying to get it out this way and let it, you know, let it seem like it's okay. But truthfully, he's putting his feelings out. He's letting people know this is how I feel. And so many people can relate to these lyrics specifically. This just sounds so much like him putting his just off the top of his head words and lyrics that come out so cool. Like the way he puts everything together and just naturally off the top of his head, and it relates to the situation, to the people, to what's going on in his life. And he finds a way to make everything like, wow, I get it. The stars gazing, the car with the moon roof in there where you can see the stars, and that he's talking about some, like here, he's obviously talking about admiring somebody. And at the beginning, he's talking about hating somebody. I feel like it's the same person. Could be two different people, but it sounds like it's the same person. He's kind of reminiscing that. I need the car with the stars in a row. Oh, elephant all in the room. She buried me in a tomb. I'm feeling overconsumed. She walking me to my dorm. I see her face in my room. When I'm alone in the room, I'ma blame that on the shrooms. Oh. Almost like he's high and he's visualizing this. He's seeing her. It's like the person's not really there because he's high on shrooms and he's seeing things and he's seeing this person. And so he's having this interaction with this person that's, I'll be curious if that's what y'all see, if that's what the truth is. But it's like he's having this relationship and this interaction with somebody because he's high. In the room, I'ma blame that on the shrooms. Feeling ridiculed, feeling like a fool, don't know what to do. Lost my heart, don't got shit to lose. Man, he's got nothing to lose and puts it all out there. I feel like that is the story of Juice WRLD's life. You know, the gambling philosophy of just putting all your chips on the table. Like you just put it all out there all the time. Like I'm just going to go for broke every time in life and relationships with using. And he just kept, you know, there's times he hit it. There's times he hit it big. There's times it was great. And then there's times where he lost everything. And that whole idea for us that maybe it's best to have a little bit of balance because he just risked so much of the time. And sometimes we have to have good boundaries, healthy relationships, and know, when is this too much? When is this toxic? Are you with somebody who's toxic? Do you hang around friends who are toxic that are bringing you down or that are stressing you out or that are, you know, riling you up or that are you know, talking you into doing things you don't want to do? And maybe it's time to pull back a little bit from that. Because he talks so much, you know, I was feeling like, you know, a fool, like. And a lot of times his lyrics to me speak to not knowing what to do. Like, I don't know what else to do. I just kind of got high. I just kind of applied a fix so that I could move on. Lost my heart, don't got shit to lose. I'm holding my man. This is the first of this song I've really heard that. I know it's already been in there, but it's like that mellow piece in there where he was just talking just real calmly and casually about life, and then all of a sudden, boom, that beat drops. I'm holding my breath and watching my step. I'm listening, reading. I love this whole thing of somebody being my depression, y'all, in a way that can be super duper healthy to be able to say you're my depression. Like when you look at somebody you've been in a, like a bad relationship with or even a bad situation with, like you're it. So I always say stay away from depression, right? You know, don't give it air to breathe so it grows, you know, suffocate that out. And that means go walking, stay active, stay away from people that are toxic. But when you notice somebody's your depression, that's a sign that's like, step away. You were lying, bitch, I'm still flexing with my heart broken. Get my heart open, I'm not hiding. Bitch, I'm still moving, I'm in slow motion. I wrote my dosage, I'm getting higher. Bitch, I still love my pills at Vils. You can't feel, I feel, you can't feel, I feel. Bitch, I still love my pills at Vils. How he just rhymes everything. It just sounds so good. Like even putting Advil in there, which, you know, to me would be for a headache. Just to get rid of the headache of that person. And sometimes it's good to take a little Advil. To me, Advil would be, you know, go out for a jog or a walk. Talk to somebody who's good for you. Read a good book, listen to good music like this. That's Advil. Like that'll help the headache of toxicity from somebody else. Think about that. That will help. I feel, bitch, I still love my pills, Advil. You can't feel, I feel, you can't feel, I feel. Oh. Man, that was so good. So different. I finally got a totally, to me, different Juice WRLD song that let me hear a whole nother side of him. I can't describe the number of Juice WRLD personalities I feel like I've seen in the music that he has released here. So thank you so much for putting this song out there, at least for recommending it so I could listen to it, because it really does help me see, you know, the different sides of him and what he went through, not only lyrically, but also the way he created music, because some of it is really dark and slow. Some of it is really poppy. Some of it is hard. And then some of it like this is kind of that, just that melodious, chill kind of vibe of sitting down in the chair, relaxing in the car, going for a drive and listening to some great music, because I cannot stop shaking my head to this music from Juice WRLD. So I'm a huge fan. Just love it. Thank you so much for that. And thanks to all the Juice WRLD fans. Thanks to all of the Reaction Therapy fans for being a part of this channel, for being a part of our family, and continuing to give me your comments, your insight, your feedback, and your support. Nick and I are loving it. So please give all that to me. Pass it on to your friends. Like, subscribe, and come back next time. And mainly because I can't wait to see you on the next Reaction Therapy.